Hey guys, today we're taking one of those old foam guns and giving it a new lease on life. First, unscrew the top nozzle where the foam comes out. Don't be shy. It's sturdier than it looks. Now take yourself a bicycle nipple. We will screw it on instead of the old nozzle. Leave a plus in the comments if you've ever repurposed a bicycle valve for something ridiculous. Then we drill two holes right into the handle. Don't worry, this old gun is stronger than my knees after 40 winters. We insert a spring into these holes. Now that's what I call a smart return system. Find yourself a radiator cap. Yes, one of those old school ones. Drill it to fit our nozzle. Insert the nozzle and screw that cap right onto the gun. Now it's starting to look like something, isn't it? Next, you'll need a coin. Pick one that fits neatly into the nipple. Drill a small hole in the middle so you can grab it with your drill. There you have it, a DIY torch nozzle. Old school engineering. Tell Tell me in the comments if you've ever made one from scratch. I want to hear your stories. Pour gasoline or solvent into the jars. Seal them tightly and connect them with a hose, like a mad scientist. Hey guys, today we're taking one of those old foam guns and giving it a new lease on life. Now fire up your compressor. Even a tiny car compressor will do. Connect it to the can of gasoline. The gun goes to the water pump. And now it's time for testing. We turned a cheap foam gun into a high temperature torch. Isn't that something? Adjust the compressor pressure to fine-tune the flame. Turn the trigger screw to set how long or short your flames dance. This torch gets hot, really hot, over 1,000 degrees. You can solder, melt, or just impress your neighbors. After a minute or two, the flame gets cleaner. It goes from a wildfire to a silent blue beast. Watch it glow. And the best part? You don't even burn the gas itself. It's the steam that does all the work. That's why it swallows the fuel. I tested it on honey. It melts like butter in a frying pan. And copper melts at about 1,085 degrees Celsius. So yeah, it's a beast.